I can hear your silence. You're speaking loud and clear now. You might as well be screaming. You always say you're helping. You think you know what's best for me. The way you help.
Hey, you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It has been a while, I have to say. It's been a long time. It's been a while. Yeah, so it's been a really long time since I filmed. I don't know what is wrong with me. I have been in a rut. Like, last week, I slept all day. I don't even know what I did. I've just been so tired. I don't know if it's the weather, the full moon, the half moon, whatever, my birth control, just my moodiness. I don't know, but I did wake up. You know what? I got a film for them. They're gonna be disappointed. And a lot of you have messaged me like, oh, how come you haven't had a video? And a lot of my new subscribers on here, they always tell me, you film often, love your looks. And I know you guys love my makeup tutorials, and you love how I film my videos and everything. I do try to film once a week, but if I don't come for me, because I'm a tired bitch. I work 6 days a week, so, and not going to the gym, so definitely makes me feel so blah, you know what I mean? Like, usually I always film when I go to the gym, especially on my day off, because I have the time to, but usually I go every morning, but I don't know if it's like what's going on in the world, the weather, the moon, whatever, or maybe it's just me, maybe I'm just like in a bitch mood, and I'm tired, and I have a headache for being such a bitch. But, yeah, I just had to film for you guys for today's look. I actually, this look I used, what am I saying? I used the James Charles palette in this tutorial. I have used this palette tons of times before, and I actually posted a few selfies with this makeup look, and tons of people told me to film a tutorial, but I just haven't had a chance to. So I finally did. This wasn't really a first impression, this is more like a recommendation. I love this palette. I've used it tons of times before, and I know a lot of people want like an in-depth like reason why they should buy this palette. Watch this video because I love it. It's definitely a big ass palette. It's a $39 palette, but it's so big. The last time Morphe created a palette this big was one of their holiday collections, and they have more blues and darker blues and golds and whatever. What? Nobody gets to say. But basically, this is the palette that you see right here. They do have a smaller one, but I have the big one. And when I did want to buy this palette, it was sold out for months and months and months. And finally, I went to Sephora, and the girl said, oh, we have one last one in the back if you don't mind waiting. And I was so happy when I got it. I hugged the girl, and the girl probably thought I was crazy. But my boyfriend was like, you don't understand this palette. Like, when I want some, I have to have it. Like, I don't care. I won't wait for PR to get it. I'll buy it on my own. That's how much, like, if I want something, I have to have it. Like, that's just who I am by nature. I have a big tattoo on my stomach, and I just wanted it for my 21st birthday. I called the tattoo shop. I was like, I need this tattoo. I got it that day, 5 hours later. A lot of pain. I had to have it. But anyways, you guys, nothing to do. This is the palette that you see right here. I love that there's like some gold colors, which I love gold color. And there's like a cranberry glitter, there's like some purple glitter, some green glitter, some like champagne glitter. I love that this is a very universal palette. It's awesome. So if you guys like more of a neutral color, you don't play with color, so you guys can go around here. If you guys love color, you guys can play around here. If you guys just like basic looks, you can play around here. And also reds for your liking. But I love this palette. I'm an artist girl. I'm a makeup artist. I love bright colors. I love playing with them. And I use this dark purple, one of the best purples I've ever used in my life. It's just so like intense. I definitely think that there's like black in there because it's like a deep dark purple, which is so hard to make. But I love it. I love it. Bitch, I love this palette. So if you guys want to have fun and play with color, definitely
buy this palette. I believe in Canadian dollars, it's like $50-something, which is so cheap for like a 39 palette. Like, come on. Like, the Anastasia one that I've always raved about, her Norvina palette, this is like $78, but this is $50 for 39 shades. Like, come on. I mean, I'm not affiliate with Morphe, but come on, bitch, you can't beat that. And the pigmentation is definitely there. It's so pretty. I just wish I wasn't so big, because it was very hard to, like, show you guys which color I was using, because I had to keep turning it. But other than that, I love the palette. The pigmentation, the payoff is there. And for me, I spend a lot of time in my blending capability. So if the eyeshadow doesn't blend, I'm mad. But this, I had no problem with it, and I loved it. Anyways, you guys, that's it for this channel. Channel, video, what am I saying? I'm a little hungry, so. Yeah, I hope you guys had a lot of fun watching this tutorial. I did play with some Swarovski crystals, which I have done lots of times on my channel, but I just wanted to have fun and play with some colors, and I love it. Bitch, I'm in love. So if you guys do try to recreate this look, please tag me. I always love when you guys tag me. I'm so sorry I haven't been filming like recently or lately. But anyways, you guys, I had so much fun filming this tutorial. So if you want to see how I created this look, just keep on watching. Where's my remote? Oh my god. Bye. Enjoy. Hey, you guys. What is up? It's been like a full 2-3 weeks I haven't filmed, I know. Such a bad YouTuber, I have to say. Yeah, so today's video, I'm gonna film, with the James Charles palette, with this palette right here. It's very dirty. I have used it tons of times before, but I thought for today's look, I would have some fun, play with some pretty colors. Which I love playgroup colors, if anyone knows me. I'm definitely a makeup artist kind of girl. I love playing with bright colors, and here's all the names, so I'm super excited. And I thought I would play with some pretty jewels for today's makeup look. I've just been so tired lately. And today I like got up around 3 and I'm like, I gotta film right now. I just gotta like get back into it. It's like hard working 6 days and then like you have to film as well. So that's why. So anyways, you guys, I already applied my foundation, my concealer, my powder, and my eyebrows. This eyebrow's kind of fucked up, but whatever. I'm just gonna work with it, and to set the entire face, I want my makeup and all my powder and stuff to really kind of settle in and kind of, basically look like skin, because it is a little powdery. But I did get more of this Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. This is one of my favorite setting sprays of all time. I'm just gonna seal the deal, basically. Make the powder and the foundation settle in, and because it is still a little damp, I'm just going to use my little Amazon fan. I love this guy. To just kind of like, I don't apply eyeshadow when my face is wet, because then the eyeshadow will be choppy and it's not a good look. Okay, moving on. Okay, we're going to use the Morphe James Charles palette. This palette is so big ass. It's huge. Like, it's literally huge. Like, I don't even know how to hold it. Like, it's huge. I'm going to use this pink color. And this is called Pinkity Drinkity. It's, like, super hard to hold for some reason. I don't know why. I might not, like, hold it the entire time, but they're just gonna work with it. Okay, and then I'm gonna use this brush. This is the R37 brush. This is such a fluffy brush, and it's one of my favorites, and I'm just gonna use this to play with the transition color. I was thinking of playing with some blues or greens, but that's not my, I'm not a blue-green kind of girl. I don't know why. Just tap the X this off. I basically just wanted to film this for you guys to show you how these shadows perform. There is a lot of interviews, reviews on it. So, I mean, you guys can watch this, but this is my review. So, we're just going to place this all over the eyelid. This color is very fair, but I'm going to do more of, like, pinks and purples today, so I just want to apply a base on, like, all over, and we're just going to play and have some fun, basically. Yeah, when this palette first came out, I could not get it, like, at all. There was, like, weeks and weeks. I even went to the store at Sephora. Finally, the girl said, I have last one. It's in the back. And she got it for me. And I was so happy. I hugged her. And my mom thought I was crazy. I was like, girl, I've been wanting this palette for forever. Then hug her. Oh, my God. This color. So cute. You can't really see it because I'm so, so pale, but whatever. Instant Retouch, a setting powder in the shade Butter. It's my favorite powder for setting under eyes. I just love it. I like it because it's not too pale. I know I am pretty pale. Rainbow Lavender is too white for me. A lot. I love this brush because it's so fluffy and it just applies that first initial color so beautifully. Ta-da! Okay, moving on. I'm going to use this magenta purple. Oh, this palette's so huge. It's so hard to like maneuver. I'm gonna use this kind of magenta purple color. It's in the shade Love That. Love That for you. Love That. Sister Stay. Okay. And now I'm going to use the Morphe M433. Love this brush for packing on color. So I'm just going to use a little at a time because I don't usually like to add a bold color with a lot of pigment. I like to go like a little at a time and build from there. I mean, if you guys like do it that way, I mean, all means. Like some people like to add the darkest color and then kind of blend lighter, lighter. I like to go lighter to darker. That's just my preference. We're gonna put this all over the lid. I mean, I just want this magenta color, like mainly on the outer corner, not so much on the eyelid part. Just like that. See, like, this is way lighter than this eye, but we're going to make it more intense. That. See, just a little at a time. I just want, like, you just add a bold color like this a little at a time. It just, it comes together, you know what I mean? Like, I find if I put a lot of this color, I'm going to sit here for like half an hour blending it. And I'm not about that, like, I don't really want to sit here forever to blend it out, you know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, if you guys do makeup like that, by all means, but this is how. Okay, we apply that color. It's looking a little choppy, but we're going to go back in. But for now, I'm going to just kind of blend it out with a lighter color. I think I want to use this really orangey color. It's kind of like a highlighter orange. It's called 518. Woo! See what I mean? This palette is so big, you guys. It's like really hard to hold, but... Okay, and then I'm just going to use that R37 brush. Keep it stay. Just because I want to. Okay, we're just going to top it off. Like, this color is pigmented. And we're just going to basically just hit the top of that. Love that color. I'm just going to blend that bitch out. Just like this. Just the very top of that love that color. See? I'm in love. I find with like really bright colors, they're very hard to develop. So like Morphe has the formula down. Because their colors are so pigmented and they just blend so beautifully. But if I'm like more of brands, don't know how to do it. Violet Voss, they definitely have brighter colors down, and I think they're not like a huge brand yet. But Morphe is a big ass brand, and the fact like they make so many palettes all the time. People just love them, and I find like every palette that they have is just so amazing. That's just my personal opinion. And if you guys do watch my channel, I love Morphe. Yes, still. Okay, now that we apply that orange, kind of blended that magenta color out, we're just going to use the same M443 brush, and I'm just going to go back in with that love that color, and I'm just going to intensify it a little bit. Just because... It's not super intense for me. Okay, now, there's so much powder in my nose. We're gonna go in with a shimmer color. I'm gonna use the MAC 242 brush. This is my favorite flat brush for applying any glitter, shimmer, anything like that. So I'm gonna add a shimmer now. It's hard because the names aren't like actually on here. I only have this sheet and I don't know what the colors are. So sorry if it's like taking me a long ass time, and it's so big. They do have a mini one, but I wish I got the mini one, but this is the big one. So I'm going to grab this kind of cranberry color shade. Sorry for my nails, you guys. I broke one the other day. This is the color Shook. And it's really pretty. And it doesn't look chunky. You know what I mean? Like, it looks really, like, fine. And, like, not super, like, glittery or chunky. And especially, like, when you're applying glitter to your eyes, you don't want it chunky because it kind of hurts your eyes when you apply it. I'm just using some MAC Fix Plus before I apply any shimmer to the lid. And I'm just going to apply this really... soft on the lid. Oh yeah, it applies really smoothly and so pretty as well. Oh yeah. Yeah. I'm in it. Sister stage. Yes, girl. This applies all over the lid. I'm gonna use a darker crease color, but I'm just like applying it all over the lid. Other eye. I cannot live without applying any like setting spray or MAC Fix Plus to my shimmers because it just makes it so intense and I love it. Whenever I do a dark color like this, my eyes always water. But today, my eyes are good, so pretty proud of that. Okay, now, I think I And then use it for the brush. Why not? Why not? Do a belly dance. Okay, I'm going to go in with the M433, and I'm going to use a darker purple color. Yeah, this dark purple color, it's called Escape. It's like, oh, this palette's so big. This really dark purple color, it's so pretty and intense. Like, it's intense, yeah. Okay, could you just stay? Okay, and I'm just going to apply with this M43 brush. Okay, and I'm just going to apply this on the outer corner of the lid. The excess off because this purple is so pigmented. Like, it's super intense. Yes. Okay. Then do the other eye. Now, I'm just going to get this kind of pencil brush, and I'm going to use the shade. I'm going to show you guys. Love that. Just on the outer corner, just for some blending. And this is the M506. I love this brush. So, like, small and quaint and dainty. I'm just going to, like, bring that. The outer corner there. This purple is so, like, these two purples definitely perform, like, so pretty. It's definitely hard to make a really intense purple that's, like, easy to blend. So I think purple is, like, one of the hardest colors to develop. I don't know if you just are. Okay, we're going to grab that R37 brush, and we're going to grab this 518 color, this really highlighter orange, kind of pumpkin kind of color. You know the vibe. I'm just going to blend that out a little bit because it's looking a little too choppy for my liking. I love this orange color. I think I did use this orange color in my Jeffree Star Red Sugar Palette tutorial, and I loved it. I'm going to use it for my under eye. It's so pretty. That powder, that Fenty powder, is so intense. I don't know. It's looking a little cakey under there, so I'm just going to tap my sponge with some setting spray just to rehydrate the under eye. Okay, yesterday I was doing laundry and I lost a nail. I was like, oh my god, I'm getting them done next week, so I should be happy about that. Okay, we're just gonna grab this a fluffy brush from Morphe. This is from the Elite Collection. This is the Morphe E17. I love this brush for applying the first initial color. So what color do I want to use? I'm going to use this kind of orangey red. It's not red, but it's definitely like a coral color for the under eye. It's called Rusted. It's like definitely not red. It's definitely not orange. It's like in between. You know what I mean? Orangey red. Look at that pigment. Ooh, girl. Okay, we're just going to put it all underneath the lower lash line. I know it looks really scary right now, but it's gonna look bomb after. Okay, I'm just gonna grab this Kylie brush. I don't know what's the name, but I got it in one of her palettes, but I love it. It's a very dome shape, and I love it for smoking out my lower lash line. Okay, we're gonna grab this yellow shade in the color B. It's like yellow. It's not like a creamy orange, yellow. It's like yellow. It's like highlighter yellow. And we're just going to grab some on that brush. We're just going to put this right on the lower lash line to blend that to the rusted color. In it. Okay, now I'm gonna grab this definer brush. This is the Morphe Y21. It's like my favorite. And then I'm just gonna grab, what color is this? This is called You're Kidding. It's like super intensely red. I love it. Like, oh, look at that. It's like red. It's kind of like a neon red almost. And if you guys watch James's channel, he definitely plays with the brighter colors. Which I don't have a problem with. And then I'm going to grab this smaller pencil brush. This is the E18. I love this brush. And then I'm going to grab, why is this palette so big? This orange color, the 518. So you guys, like, you know what I mean? How big this is? It's like, it's just crazy how big this palette is. It's like, it's a little much. I definitely wish I got the mini one because it would probably like be easier for me to use. But we're just gonna call this orange color. And just to blend that You're Kidding color. Okay, now we're going to grab that Kylie brush. We're going to use that 518 color. I'm just going to bring it down a little bit. I live for a lower lash line. Kidding me? And I want it to blend in kind of with my blush later. Might add more later, but we'll see. Okay, we're gonna use some. Gonna use some concealer. I've been using the Jouer Essential High Coverage Liquid Concealer. This is in the shade Custard. I used this earlier for my under eye, but I'm just gonna conceal my brow bone really quickly, just because. I'm sure I have a really intense look. I always clean up my brows with concealer. Just like makes such a difference. Okay, and then for brow highlight, I think I'm just going to use some Champagne Pop. So I like to be Champagne Poppin' from Becca. I'm going to use... This is the Morphe M213. I love this brush for highlighting my brow bone. Okay. Oh, I'm going to apply it first because that concealer is so tall. For inner corner, we're not going to do inner corner highlight. We're going to do something different today. I'm going to use the Morphe Y22. I love this for my inner corner. And I just want to do something different because we're going to add jewels later. So we're not going to do an actual inner corner highlight. But I'm going to use this yellow shade in B. Ugh. This is such a big palette. Okay, I'm going to use... And I never do stuff like this, ever. But I want to be different today. So just placing it there. Oh, yeah. I'm in it. Yes, honey. And then this is just going to be the base for when we add Swarovski crystals after, which when I mentioned that on my social media, you guys were like living. Basically, which I'm happy that you guys are excited to play with some Swarovskis like I am. Okay, we're gonna put this big ass palette away because it's very big. Okay, and then I'm gonna use some eyeliner. I just bought this. I bought a bunch of stuff from MAC Cosmetics a few weeks ago, and I've been wanting this eyeliner, and it's always sold out for some reason, but this is the MAC Cosmetics Chromographic Pencil in the shade Primary Yellow. It's like yellow, you guys. I did use it a few weeks ago, but it's pigmented and I love it. So you're just going to apply this. I can't see. All in the water. There, that's intense. I usually do this step with eyeshadow, but I just think it's easier with eyeliner. Just because it's looking a little flat, I want to use this Kat Von D shade and light palette. I'm going to use these two highlighting shades. I know this palette's very dirty, but I love it because it has such a yellow base to it. It definitely makes the under eye pop. Just makes my eye look complete, you know? Yes, bitch. Okay, now we're going to use some mascara. I'm actually using a different mascara today. This is old, but it still is usable, and I want to use it. This is the L'Oreal Paris Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara. I forgot how much I love this mascara. All on the lashes. For some reason, like, you know how you put mascara, like, people open their mouth? And when I apply top mascara, I don't open my mouth. It's the bottom part. I have to open my mouth or eyeliner. I don't know. That's, like, new thing I just learned. Maybe I'm not getting good at this, controlling my mouth. Perfect. Oh yeah, that's pretty. I'm going to use these double lift intoxicating lashes from Flutter. They're my favorite lashes. And they're going to look really pretty with this look. I was going to use Miami from Lily Lashes, but I don't have any right now. You know. I find like they don't really last that long because they're very wispy, but I don't know. I just love the Flutter ones so much. But if you guys like Miami and that's your thing... I know Nikita Dragon loves Miami as well because they're like wispy and frisky. Ta-da! That's so cute. Look at a difference. Look at a difference. Look. What a difference lashes make. I love it. I love it. I don't know how girls or guys don't wear lashes. Like, I'm sorry. My boyfriend, like, was making fun of me the other day. He's like, you literally have no lashes. He does say, like, I have thick lashes. But he says they're short. He's got actually really nice long lashes. He is like, his hair is silver now, but he used to be blonde. So his lashes are very blonde. And they're so long. Like, he'll sit there. Like, they poke him in the eye. That's how long they are. He'll sit there and he'll just pull them out. I'm like, what are you doing? But, yeah. Yeah, he has actually really nice lashes. So jealous. How come all the guys have long lashes? Okay. I'm gonna let this dry. This eye is always like a problem for me. I just poke myself in the eye. And his eye always waters too. Ugh. Bitch. Ta-da! So pretty, you guys. Fine, fresh. Is that what he says? I don't know. Alright. It's cooking pretty good. I'm just gonna blend a little more up here. Just because I want to. Okay, now we're going to apply some gems. My favorite part of the video. I'm sure you guys are super excited as well. Okay, I'm going to use... I bought these from Michael's, but I just put them in this old Laura Mercier traveling case. Because, I don't know. It's like when you open the package, it kind of falls everywhere, and I didn't want to lose them. I'm going to put some yellow ones in my inner corner. I'm just going to get them out. Quickly. I need like small yellow ones, so I'm gonna like dig in this jar here. Okay, I'm gonna actually take some of my duo glue. I think I have done Swarovski crystals on my channel before, but usually I use lash glue because it comes right off and it lasts all day, and this one is waterproof, so this is why I like it. So.
I'm gonna hold it like this and I'm gonna apply some glue.
And then I like to wait 10 seconds. Because if you wait too long, it kind of stick to the tweezers and then I have trouble with it. Okay, now we're just gonna basically pop it on there like that. And then you have some wiggle room. And this is the end of your tweezers. Like, boom, ta-da! See, instead of adding like a shimmery inner corner, I just add this little gem, and that's your gem, y'all. Super cute. Yeah, I love it. 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 Yeah, I just gotta find, like, when I do this, it's a little too much, but I don't know. I love it so much. Okay, I think I want to do an orange one just above my iris on each side. So let me look for an orange. Small gem, y'all. There's one. And there's two. I always make sure there's no extra glue on my tweezers because it'll like ruin your makeup. Okay, we're gonna grab an orange one. It's hard to grab. I think I dropped one, but whatever. Whatever. I definitely dropped one. But I have a whole jar, so who cares? Okay, 10 seconds. Okay, I'm just gonna pop this. There. It just got too high. I don't think so. Okay, we're gonna do the other one. Usually I do light pink for this end. I think I'm gonna do light pink, not dark pink. Okay. Okay. This glue, it smells strong. 10 seconds. Okay, let me see what color. There. Yeah. I'm in it. Okay, we're gonna do the other eye. Ta-da! Done. See? And that's your gems, y'all. It's not that hard. hard to do, actually. Super easy. But I'm telling you, that 10-second trick, I know I wait 60 seconds for my lashes, but it's different when you do with gems. So if it's too tacky, you can't, like, it'll get stuck on your toes and you can't actually apply it. Just my personal opinion, y'all. Okay, now we're going to do the rest of the face. I don't want to cut the video on just the eyes. It's kind of weird. Okay, I'm going to use the Shade and Light contour palette from Kat Von D. And I'm going to use these two darker shades. One is, this one's more taupe and this is more of a darker one. And then I'm going to use this brush. I've been loving this. I know it's kind of like dented, but I've been loving this brush. This is the Morphe M530. I love it. Especially using this contour palette with it. It just applies the contour so beautifully because it's a goat hair. I love goat hair brushes. I just love it. I don't know why. Just really leave me. I don't want to go too dark. Like that. Perfect. Okay. For bronzer, I think I'm just going to use this Morphe bronzer because I've been loving it recently because it's not too dark. It's not too red, not too orange. I love it. This is the Morphe GLAM Bronze Face and Body Bronzer in the shade Icon. This was from their summer collection a few years ago. They do have the original packaging, which is all black, but this is the one I have right now. Okay, we're just gonna use, I'm using this Morphe Tense Jaclyn Hill Bronzer Brush. This is the JH02. I love this brush. It just applies the bronzer. It's so amazing. And I love Morphe brushes, if you guys know that. Because I don't want to be too dark for my cheeks. I want the main focus to be the eye look. I'm in it. Okay, now, for bakeage, I'm going to use the CoverFX Perfect Setting Powder. Love this powder. I bought this from Beautylish because they still have it. I'm just going to dump some of the powder out. But Dior doesn't have it anymore, and I don't know why. It's really sad because I love this powder. It's definitely, like, more hydrating than the Laura Mercier, and I love it. So I'm just going to dip on one side of the Morphe Beauty Spread. And I'm just going to draw a line. Yeah, I love this powder for baking. It's really good for setting your face too, but it doesn't have shimmer in it. But I wish so far I had it. They have the darker one. I think it's on sale. I don't know if they're revamping the whole CoverFX line, but I'm like, what the hell? but if you guys love this powder as much as I do, Beautylish does have it. I think it's like only 40 something, which the Laura Mercier is a little more expensive. It's I think it's like 55 something. Okay, I'm just gonna contour my nose really quickly. This is the Morphe from the Elite Collection, the E21, and I'm just gonna contour my nose with that Morphe Icon bronzer. Just really lightly. I don't want to contour it too much because I do have a really high bridge. I usually use my Kylie Slanted Go hairbrush, but I've been loving this one because it's like bigger. It like takes so quickly to like contour my nose, see? And then I'm done. Done, bitch. Okay. I'm just gonna take that nose powder away. Now I'm just gonna take that powder away. I don't want to leave it on too long down here because I'm not really oily down here and I get really dry here. That powder was on for a really long time just for hydration. And then we're going to go back in with the Kat Von D Shaded Light Palette. I'm going to use these two highlighting shades just to add some highlight to my nose. I cannot live without nose highlights. Like, look, it just makes my nose, especially because we added that bronzer for contour powder, it just... It looks kind of scary, but I'm into it. Alright, do the upper lip. 24 out. Okay. Now, I'm just going to take that powder away. I don't want to leave it on too long down here because I'm not really oily down here and I get really dry here. We're done, you guys. Do you guys hear the drama with Morphe and Jeffree Star now that I'm using one of her brushes? I don't know. Morphe just announced that they're not going to carry or affiliate or, like, have any of his products. Especially, like, I think his line, he did create a palette and a couple brushes with Morphe. And he also sells a lot of his products on their U.S. site and I believe in their stores. But all of a sudden, Morphe decided... they're not gonna do that anymore. And I was like, oh my god, what is the tea, yo? Like, drama in the beauty community. Okay, we're just gonna tap that matte fix plus under the face because we did apply that powder. Anytime I like remove any bakage, I always like to apply some hydration with matte fix plus or any setting spray with the sponge. It just like adds such a difference. Yeah. I don't know what happened. Like, I was like, whoa. And if you guys follow Jeffree Star and Morphe, they do have a long-term relationship, but not anymore. Obviously, something happened. But I want to know what happened. But it also could be just gossip, too. Like, I'm a very firm believer. Like, you know, don't believe everything you hear or read because you don't know the real truth, right? It's... So I never tell anyone anything. Okay. So we're just gonna pack that in. Okay, done. Now I'm gonna apply some blush. And I think I wanna keep it really like vibrant and especially for blush. I'm just gonna go in with the MAC Cosmetics. This is Modern Mandarin. It's like a really corally kind of pigmented blush. I'm just going to use this Morphe Times Jaclyn Hill JH06. I'm just going to use this brush because why not? Okay, I'm just going to apply to the cheekbones. I want to keep this look really warm, so that's why I'm using this color. And if you guys do watch my channel, I like to mix this color with copper tone. I just love it. But I want it more coral today, so that's why I'm not mixing with it with anything else. I think I'm gonna curl my hair today, you guys. I was gonna flat iron it, but who am I kidding? I'm a curl girl. Before we apply actual highlight, I'm just gonna use the Laura Mercier translucent setting powder in the shade Glow. We're just going to apply this to the cheekbones because why not? I think I'm going to use this brush. This is the Morphe M509. I'm just going to use this because I want to. And I'm just going to apply this really lightly because I just want like a really light inner glow. I usually use the Hourglass, but I just want to use this today. I don't know. So this one's a little more intense than the Hourglass one. And I want a more kind of glowy effect. Yeah. That's so pretty. Just on the apples of the cheeks. I'm really into this look, you guys. I'm here. And the nose, chin, I'm going to do forehead. Yeah. And then I'm with it. Okay, now for the actual highlights. Sorry, I just have to comb my sleeves off, but I have makeup on my hands. I don't want to touch my new sweater. Okay, now before we apply actual highlights, I feel like I'm so far from you guys. I'm going to use the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist just to make it more intense, and I love doing this step, you guys know. Love it. It's very similar from the gold collection. If you see, yeah. But whatever. Okay, we're just going to apply this to the cheekbones. I'm going to use another highlight, but I want to use this first as the base. I'm just bringing that to the temple of the cheek. Oh yeah, I love champagne pop. It's just so intense and beautiful. It's like the perfect shade for every skin tone. Oh my god, I forgot. I can wear gloss today. Ever since the whole coronavirus and I have to wear a stupid mask, I can't wear lip gloss, which is just stupid. I don't know how much longer this is going to last, but I'm getting tired of it. Real tired. Okay. Actually, I'm going to use the beauty sponge now just to make it more intense with the same champagne pop color. I love using a sponge for a fun highlight. It just makes it so intense, you know? Forehead, upper lip, and chin. Okay, now I'm going to apply a loose highlighter. I got these in the mail a couple days ago. These are the Morphe. I've been using a lot of Morphe today. But these are the Morphe times Coca-Cola collaboration. So this is, what is it called? It's a loose highlighter. So they're not very big, but they're intense. And I got three colors. So this one's the lightest. This is kind of like a white color. This is the color Bubbly Bear. And then I have more of a kind of golden shade. I probably use this one for today's look because we did a very gold highlight. Kind of champagne kind of golden highlight. This is called Pop It. And then this one's more of a copper kind of gold. This one is called Serve Sparkling. And I've been using these for the last few days and I love it. I love it. Okay, I'm going to show you. I'm going to do like a swatch. Please, come on. How can I not? I've been using them the last few days and I love them. And they're intense. Like, you kidding me? It's like subtle, but it's very buildable, which I love. And they're so beautiful. And you guys know I'm definitely a sucker for any loose highlighter. Come on. And just apply to the skin. Just I think I'm just going to use this one. This is the Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in the shade Spice. It's actually really pretty. I want to do a nude. I know that for sure. I want to do not too of a nude. And I actually really love Milani's lip liners. They apply it very creamy. I like it because it's not too nude, but I'm going to apply like a really nude today. For liquid lip, I think I'm just going to go in with an oldie but a goodie. This is the Jeffree Star Allure Liquid Lipstick in the shade A Mannequin. It smells so good. And I love this nude. I love it. It's so nude. I'm in it. For lip gloss, oh my god, I can actually wear lip gloss. So exciting. I'm going to go in with Kylie Cosmetics gloss in the shade So Cute. This is her Fearless gloss, and I love it. I actually have to get more, I think, because she's running low, girl. Yes, honey. Oh my god, I actually really do love wearing lip gloss. Okay, just to seal the deal one more time before we apply any brow gel or lower lash mascara, we're going to apply some more of that Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. I usually like to do this step right before mascara because if I apply this after my mascara, the wetness will make my mascara smear, and I'm not about that life. Okay, just going to spray for one more time. The clear brow gel. This is my favorite brow gel because it is like Gorilla Glue. Your eyebrows do not move with this stuff. Just gonna lightly brush my eyebrows up. I can't leave the house without brow gel. Inner corner highlight, brow highlight, and lip gloss. Those are my main things. Oh, and lashes. And then we're going to use the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. This is my favorite lower lash mascara. I love the wand because it's so skinny. The only skinny thing I like. Just kidding! I shouldn't have said that. Oh well. So pretty. I am love. Okay, I'm going to curl my hair real quickly. I'll be right back, y'all.
There we go, you guys. That's it for this video. I curled my hair really quickly. I haven't curled my hair in so long. I actually love it. And I added my favorite Irie collection Baker the Hoop diamond earrings. I'll link them below if you guys do want to get them. They're my favorite earrings of all time. Anyways, you guys, that's it for this video tutorial. I had so much fun. I'm actually really glad I filmed because, like, been like in a rut. I'm just so tired all the time. I'm definitely thinking it's because of the gym. I miss the gym. Like, honestly, a lot of people told me just walk outside. It's not the same. I'm telling you, I love doing squats, deadlifts, lifting weights, all that motherfucking shit, treadmill, run, everything. Like, it drives my soul to go to the gym, and right now I can't. But I did hear to Steve Nash, he went out of business, bankrupt, whatever. So the gym, they're renaming it to Just Fitness World. It was used to be called that before, and then all of a sudden they took the Steve Nash name, and the new investors just gonna call Fitness World. But they're revamping everything and cleaning. So I haven't gone to the gym in like literally 4 or 5 months, and mentally, it's getting to me. Like, I'm telling you, I'm definitely moody. I'm definitely, like, not in a good mood most of the time. But I'm just living my best life, y'all. And why not living your best life in
makeup and like looking great. But that's it for this tutorial. I'm not gonna make a really long outro like I always do. Wasn't really talking too much in the video. I kind of have a headache. I just gotta get back into it, you know, and I haven't been filming like a lot of the time, but I promise you guys I'm gonna try, because definitely this is my first love for you guys. I love filming for you guys. I know you guys love my videos. If you guys have any ideas for me to film, I would love to create it and then like film it on my day off, which I'm totally open to. But anyways, you guys, I love how this tutorial look turned out, and I love the gems. I do this very often. I did post a selfie a few months ago and talked to my friends that I should do a tutorial on this, and it finally is here. And I just love how the gems look, how I place them, the whole vibe. I love the brightness. I definitely recommend this James Charles palette. It's a great pigment. It's definitely like an artist palette. It's such a great palette. The pigmentation is definitely there. If you guys don't like the how big it is, definitely get the mini, but they didn't have the mini when I got this. I think he just released it like a few months ago, so I actually got my mom's friend's kid this palette, and she really wanted it. She's like 1 year old, and I bought it for her because she really wanted it so much. So, and it was perfect for her, so she was like that. But I have the big one because it's just so big ass. But definitely the colors are there. The pigmentation is there. It's beautiful. This purple color, oh my god, loved it. Love that color. I just loved the shimmers in the palette, everything about this palette. Definitely give it a go. I believe it's still on sale, or if they still have it. You can get it at Sephora or Morphe itself. I think I got this one at Sephora. And I have used the black one. The black is really black. You want a really intense black shadow. Loved this palette. So yeah, if you guys do or are debating that you do want to get this palette, I definitely recommend it. It's an awesome palette. And there's definitely shades in here that I use on other looks, like that orange shade. Love that orange shade. I have used that color before in the past. There's lots of colors here I would use. So yeah, if you guys don't like color, then don't get this. But there is lots of neutral colors in this palette. So if you guys like oranges or reds, or you're really like that color, don't get it. But anyways, you guys, I had so much fun basically doing this tutorial, and I also loved this Morphe times Coca-Cola loose highlighter. Loved it. If you guys want to get it, definitely recommend it. The new product. I just wanted to try it and show you guys how much I've been loving this product. But yeah, enough chit-chatting for today. If you guys do recreate this makeup tutorial or any of my looks here on my channel, definitely tag me. I always keep my socials in the description box. But yeah, I'm gonna try and film and not be like a bad YouTuber as much as I can. I don't know. Yeah, for the next look. I was thinking of doing like a sober glam cut piece, because I love the cut piece, and you know, I just want to have fun. I've been really loving sober tutorials and sober looks lately, and I think it complements my eye color so well, so I might do that for my next video. Don't know when I'm gonna film, but I'll try to film as soon as I can. But yeah, I loved how everything turned out. I love this tutorial. Love the lip combination. This is definitely my signature lip combination. Love it. Yeah. Sister Slay it. Definitely Sister Slay the lip color. Anyways, you guys, I love you so much. Till next time. See ya.
Silence, you're speaking loud and clear now.